Dear students, in this class we are going to discuss about classification of matter. So this classification of matter is done on the basis of chemical composition of matter. So on the basis of chemical composition of matter, so matter is classified into mainly two types. One is mixtures, another one is pure substances. Mixtures and pure substances. Again, mixtures are further classified into two types, homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. So similarly, pure substances are further classified into elements and compounds. Okay, so on the basis of chemical composition, so this matter is classified into two types. One is mixtures. Another one is pure substances. And further, mixtures are classified into two types, homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures. Similarly, pure substances are further classified into two types, elements and compounds. They are further classified as elements and compounds. So first we will see, so what are the mixtures? Okay, so matter is classified into mixtures and pure substances. So first we will see what are the mixtures, what are the different types of mixtures. Okay, so mixtures, a mixture contains particles of two or more pure substances and which are present in any ratio. So therefore the composition of mixture is variable. It is going to change because components are not present in a fixed ratio, so they can present in any ratio, so that's why its composition is variable. Pure substances forming mixture are called components. Pure substances which are present in our mixtures, they are called as components. Example, sugar solution, air, tea, etc. So what are the mixture means? So mixtures are in mixture which contain particles of, mixtures contain particles of two or more pure substances and they are present in any ratio. So therefore its composition is variable, and pure substances which are forming mixture, they are called components. Example, sugar solution, air, tea, etc. So first we'll write about mixtures. So in mixtures, a mixture contains particles of two or more pure substances and they are present in any ratio. Hence, its composition is variable. Its composition changes. Variable means the composition changes. And the pure substances which are forming mixture, they are called components. Pure substances forming mixture, are called components. Okay, so example, sugar solution, air, comma tea, etc. Sugar solution, air, or tea. So these are some examples for mixtures. So now let us discuss about classification of mixtures. As you already know, there are two types of mixtures. So mixtures are classified into two types: homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. So dear students, homo means what? Homo means same. What is going to be same here means the composition is going to be uniform, or the composition is going to same or uniform throughout the mixture here. So first let us discuss about homogeneous mixture. So in this mixture, components are completely mixed with each other. In homogeneous mixture, the components are completely mixed with each other. This means particles of the mixture is uniform. Particles of the components are uniformly distributed. They are uniform. They are same everywhere. They are uniformly distributed throughout the mixture. Hence, the composition of this mixture is uniform throughout. So very simple, what is homogeneous mixture means? So a mixture, or in this mixture, the components are completely mixed with each other. So this means particles of the components are uniformly distributed throughout. Okay, so therefore the composition is uniform throughout. Example, sugar solution. Or you can take air, because a mixture of different gases are present in the air. So whenever the gases are present, they are going to form a homogeneous mixture, as their composition is uniform. Their composition is same throughout. So that's why it is a homogeneous mixture. Coming to the next class, that is heterogeneous mixture. So dear students, hetero means different. So what is different here? The composition is different. So in homogeneous, homo means same means uniform, the composition is uniform. Heterogeneous means different, in this mixture the composition is not uniform. The composition is not uniform throughout, and sometimes different components are visible. Sometimes you can see the different components which are present in the mixture. So in heterogeneous mixture, composition is not uniform throughout, and sometimes different components are visible. Sometimes different components are visible. You can easily identify the different components present in heterogeneous mixture. So components of the heterogeneous mixture, they can be separated by simple physical methods. They can be separated by simple physical methods like hand picking, filtration, crystallization, distillation. By using such simple methods, you can separate the different components of heterogeneous mixtures. So this is about homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures. Let us write down few points regarding homogeneous and heterogeneous mixtures. So first one, homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture. In this mixture, the components are completely mix with each other. The particles of the components are uniformly distributed throughout the bulk of mixture. Hence, its composition is uniform. Its composition is uniform throughout. Example, sugar solution. And you can take the example of air also, etc. Next, coming to another type, that is heterogeneous mixture. Second one, heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture. In this mixture, the components are not uniform throughout. Sometimes different components are visible. Example, a mixture of salt and sugar, or you can have the example of rice and sand, or a mixture of rice and with some dirt, or pulses with some dirt, or grains with some dirt. So these can be example for heterogeneous mixtures. Okay, so we can mixture of salt and sugar. Mixture of salt and sugar. Or we can have a mixture of pulses and grains. Grains and pulses with some dates. Okay. So now I have already told you, in heterogeneous mixtures, sometimes different components are visible. So that's why you can separate these components by using simple physical methods. Okay. So like we have hand picking, we have filtration, crystallization, distillation. So by using such methods, you can easily separate the components of a heterogeneous mixture. Components of this mixture. Mixture can be separated using simple physical methods. Such as hand picking. Suppose some dirt is present or stones are present in the rice, you can use hand picking. Filtration, you know, by using a filter, you can separate the components. So we have distillation. We will study in detail about distillation and crystallization in organic chemistry. So these are the simple physical methods by using we can separate the different components of the heterogeneous mixtures. So this is about mixtures and different types of mixtures. So let us see about pure substances. So the next classification is pure substances. Okay. So these pure substances have characteristics different from the mixtures. Constituents of pure substances have, constituent particles of pure substances have a fixed ratio. They are present in a fixed ratio. So that's why they have a fixed composition. The composition is not variable here, as in case of mixture. In case of mixture, constituent particles can be present in any ratio. But here, in case of pure substances, the constituent particles of the pure substances have fixed composition. Example, copper, silver, gold, water, or you can take the example of glucose. So dear students, you might be knowing that the molecular formula of glucose is C6H12O6. So what are the different components present? So what are the different elements present in this glucose? So this glucose contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, and they are present in a fixed ratio. If you see glucose, C6H12 and O6. So in glucose, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, they are present in the fixed ratio. If you simplify, you will see that carbon and hydrogen and oxygen, they are present in the ratio 1:2:1. Means they have a fixed ratio. Okay. So particles of the pure substances, they are always present in a fixed ratio. So, and they are present in the same composition, their particles are present in same composition. Like our mixtures, components of pure substances cannot be separated by simple physical methods. Like mixtures, the components of pure substances cannot be separated by simple physical methods. So this is about pure substances. Okay, so let's write a few points about pure substances. So they have characteristic different from mixtures. They have characteristics different from the mixtures. Constituent particles of pure substances have fixed composition. Yes, the constituent particles have fixed composition. Example, copper, silver, gold, or we can have gold, water, or you can take glucose. So if you take the example of glucose, you will see that different elements. So this glucose is a pure substance because in this glucose, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, they are present in the fixed ratio. Glucose contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. They are present in a fixed ratio. So that's why it is a pure substance. So glucose is a pure substance because in glucose we have carbon, hydrogen and oxygen which are present in a fixed ratio. Okay, so now components of pure substances cannot be separated by simple physical methods. So in case of mixtures, I have told you the components of the mixture can be separated by simple physical methods. But in case of pure substances, as the constituent particles are having a definite ratio, fixed ratio, we cannot separate them using simple physical methods. Components of pure substances cannot be separated by simple physical methods. Okay, so yes, when we compare the separation of the constituent particle, it is possible in case of mixture by using simple methods, whereas in pure substances you cannot separate the constituent particles of the pure substances which are present in a definite ratio or fixed ratio. So now coming to further classification of pure substances. So dear students, already you know that. So pure substances are further classified into elements and compounds. They are further classified into elements and compounds. So So first let us talk about elements. Let us see about elements. So what are the elements? So very simple question. So what are the elements mean? So already we know that it is a pure substance. Elements are nothing but pure substances. So these are the pure substances which are made up of only one kind of atoms. So these are the pure substances which are made up of only one type of atoms or only one kind of atoms. So these elements can exist in the form of atoms or molecules. So what are the elements? Pure substances which are made up of only one type of atoms. They are made up of only one type of atoms. So they may be atoms or they can exist in the form of molecules. Examples: sodium, copper, silver, or you can take the gases like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Okay, so if you take the example of copper, silver or sodium, so in these elements the constituents are atoms. Means these elements exist in the form of atoms. When you take the gases like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, so we have H2, N2, O2 like that. So in these case the elements are present in the form of molecules, and these molecules are formed by the combination of two different atoms. It is formed by the combination of two different atoms. Okay, so elements are pure substances which are formed by only one type of atoms. So they are formed by only one type of atoms. Pure substances which are formed by only one kind of atoms. Only one kind of atoms. Atoms. So these particles may exist. These particles may exist as atoms or molecules. Okay, so example: sodium. We can have copper, silver, hydrogen, you can take nitrogen, etc. When you come to the cases of sodium, copper or silver, so in these elements the constituents are nothing but atoms. Atoms means these elements exist in the form of atoms. When you take the gases like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, okay, so in such cases what happens? So they exist in the form of molecules. So these elements are nothing but molecules, and these molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. So these molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. I'll show you how it is. Okay, so when you talk of sodium, copper or silver and hydrogen, so they are present. Sodium, copper and silver, if you take, so they are present in the form of atoms. If you take the hydrogen, nitrogen or oxygen, they are present in the form of gases. They are present in the form of molecules. Okay, so I'm writing here some elements like नाइट्रोजन ऑक्सीजन गैसेस एक्सिस्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एक्सिस्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ they exist in the form of gases they exist in the form of molecules some elements like if you take hydrogen in the form of H2 nitrogen gas is N2 similarly oxygen gas is O2 they are present in the form of molecules I have told you so these molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. So we can have atoms of some different elements. So you can take hydrogen and oxygen, nitrogen. So depending upon the size, I am writing here copper. You can take sodium. So these are atoms of different elements. These are atoms of different elements. I have told you molecules are formed when atoms are going to combine. So molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. For example, how H2 molecule is formed? So let us take one atom of hydrogen that combines with another atom of hydrogen to form H2 molecule like this. So this is H2 molecule formed by the combination of two hydrogen atoms. So this one is atom of hydrogen. So this is atom of hydrogen. So this is another atom of hydrogen. So now here it is a molecule of H2. It is the molecule of hydrogen that is in the form of H2. So similarly you can take O2 molecule. How a O2 is formed? By the combination of two oxygen atom in the same way. Yes. So this is atom of oxygen. So this is another atom of oxygen. So this is molecule of oxygen. So that is nothing but O2 molecule. It is H2 molecule. Molecule of hydrogen, okay, and this is O2 molecule. So that's what I have written here. Some elements like gases H2, O2, N2, which are made up of same atoms, which should be made up of same atoms, then only they are called as elements. So this is about one of the classification of few substances, elements. So next we will move to another category, compounds. Next we will discuss about compounds. The second classification is compounds. So what are the compounds? When two or more atoms of different elements combine together in a fixed ratio, a molecule of compound is formed. When two or more atoms of different elements While I was discussing about elements, what I have told, they are pure substances which are formed by only one kind of atoms. Though there is a molecules are present, like we have O2, oxygen. O2 is made up of only oxygen, O. N2 is made up of only nitrogen, N. So they are called atoms of same elements. So now what I am telling is, so compounds are formed when atoms of two or more than two different elements. So two or more atoms of different elements, and they combine together in a fixed ratio, in a definite ratio, then a molecule of compound is formed. The constituents of compound cannot be separated by simple physical methods. The constituents of compounds cannot be separated by simple physical methods. Instead, the constituents of compound can be separated by chemical methods. They can be separated by chemical methods. Coming to examples, so we can have the example of water, ammonia, carbon dioxide. They are the example for compounds. If you take the example of water, which is nothing but H2O. So two different atoms of two different elements are present, and hydrogen and oxygen, they are present in the ratio 2:1. Similarly, ammonia, NH3. So NH3 is also a compound, because atoms of different elements, they are present in the fixed ratio 1:3. Nitrogen and hydrogen, they are present in the ratio 1:3. So similarly, you can take carbon dioxide, CO2. CO2 is also a compound, because atoms of different elements, they are present in a definite ratio. Carbon and oxygen, they are present in the ratio 1:2. So like that, when two or more atoms of different elements, they combine together in a definite ratio, in a fixed ratio, a molecule of compound is formed. Let us write down about compounds. When two or more atoms of different elements combine together in a definite ratio, a molecule of compound is formed. Okay. So the constituents of the compound cannot be separated into simpler substance by physical methods. So constituents of the compound cannot be separated by simple physical methods. But they can be separated by chemical methods. Example, water, ammonia, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एटसेट्रा. सो व्हाई वाटर मींस, बिकॉज इन वाटर हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द रेशियो 2:1. सिमिलरली अमोनिया मींस NH3, इन विच नाइट्रोजन एंड हाइड्रोजन दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द रेशियो 1:3. सो सिमिलरली इन कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड दैट इज नथिंग बट CO2, कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द रेशियो 1:2. सो दैट्स व्हाई दे आर कंसिडर्ड एज कंपाउंड्स. दे आर कंसिडर्ड एज कंपाउंड्स. सो नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द सिंपल डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन कंपाउंड्स एंड मिक्सचर्स. सी इन कंपाउंड्स व्हाट हैपन्स, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स, द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स इज गोइंग टू चेंज एंड इट फॉर्म्स ए कंपाउंड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सी H2O वाटर इज ए कंपाउंड. इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाई टू एलिमेंट्स H2 एंड O2. हाइड्रोजन गैस एंड ऑक्सीजन गैस दे आर गोइंग टू कंबाइन टू फॉर्म वॉट, वाटर. सो वाटर इज ए कंपाउंड, whereas H2 एंड O2 आर एलिमेंट्स. ओके, सो नाउ सी द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ H2 एंड O2. बोथ आर सपोर्टर फॉर सी बोथ आर कंबस्टिबल. ओके, सो H2 इज ऑल्सो हाईली कंबस्टिबल गैस. सिमिलरली इवन ऑक्सीजन इज ऑल्सो सपोर्टर फॉर कंबशन. But when it comes to water molecule, when they combine to form water molecule, so H2 is a fire extinguisher. See, the property is entirely different. Whereas H2 and O2 are supporter for combustion, when it forms H2O, this H2O it acts as fire extinguisher. So entirely different property when they are present as elements and when they form the compounds. Okay, so constituents loses their property when they form a compound, but in case of mixture constituents always retain their properties. So now, in order to understand compounds and mixtures, so let us have some two or three differences between compounds and mixtures. Okay, so differences between compounds and mixtures. Okay, we'll write here differences between compounds and mixtures. Say here it is compounds, mixtures. Okay, so let us have some two or three simple differences, and it can be asked for 2 marks. Okay, so in compounds, constituents, let us talking about the how the constituents are present in compound. Constituents are always present in a fixed ratio, whereas in case of mixture, constituents can be present in any ratio. Okay? Constituents are present in fixed ratio. So here, constituents are present in any ratio. Okay. Second one. See, in compounds, constituents cannot be separated by physical methods. Instead, they can be separated by chemical methods, I have told you. So, but in case of mixture, the constituents can be separated by simple physical methods. They can be separated by simple physical methods. Constituents cannot be separated by physical methods cannot be separated by physical methods. So constituents can be separated by can be separated by physical methods. Can be separated by physical methods. So coming to the property of constituents and property of compounds. So properties are going to change. Okay. So the properties of compounds are different from property of constituents. Property of compounds are different from property of constituents. Whereas in mixtures, constituents retain their properties. In mixtures, constituents retain their properties. Properties of compounds are different from those of constituents. Okay, so here constituents retain their properties. Constituents retain their properties in mixtures. So these are some differences that can make you understand what are compounds and what are the mixtures. So this is the brief classification of our matter on the basis of chemical composition. So the next concept is properties of matter and their measurements. So every substance has some its unique properties. So every substance is associated with its unique properties, and these properties may be physical properties and chemical properties. Physical and chemical properties. So what are the physical properties means? So properties which can be measured or observed without changing the composition of substance. Okay, so we are going to measure the properties or we are going to observe these properties without changing its composition. So such properties are called physical properties. Example, color, odor, melting point, boiling point, and even density. So while measuring these properties, so there will be no chemical change in the composition of the substances. It means to say that chemically the composition of substance is not going to change when we measure such properties. So coming to next category, chemical properties. So for chemical properties, what happened? So these are the properties which require a chemical change to occur. So in this, what happens? The composition is going to change. So chemically the composition is going to change. So chemical property require chemical change to occur. In other words, so chemical properties are nothing but the characteristic chemical reactions of the different substances. Example, you can take acidity, basicity, combustibility, like that we can have the different characteristic reactions of the substances are included in chemical properties. So properties are of two types, physical and chemical. So physical properties are those which are measured or observed without changing the composition of the matter or composition of the substance. Example, you can have color, odor, melting point, boiling point, density. And chemical properties are those which require a chemical change to occur. So examples are, so characteristic chemical reactions of the substances like acidity, basicity, combustibility. Okay, so let us write about the different properties. So mainly there are properties can be classified into two categories. Properties can be classified into two types. One is physical properties which can be measured or observed without changing composition of substance or changing composition of substance are called physical properties. Example, color, odor, boiling point, melting point, and even we can have density also. So in the physical properties, the chemical composition is not going to change. So totally its composition remains same, its composition is not going to change. Next, chemical properties. Chemical properties These properties require a chemical change to occur. The examples of chemical properties are characteristic reactions of different substances. Example, acidity, acidic character, basicity, combustibility, ability to undergo combustion, etc. So this is about two different types of properties, physical and chemical properties.